Good morning, students. My name is Dr. B. Suresh Babu, working as a professor in Mechanical Engineering Department. As a part of online classes, today's presentation is on design of flywheel. So we are going to solve few problems in this design of flywheel concept. Already in the previous class, I have given the parameters that are included in this flywheel. The parameters for design of the flywheel is thickness, breadth, and mass of the flywheel. So what is a flywheel? A flywheel is a huge rotating mass which is a ability to absorb the energy when excess energy is produced by the engine. At the same time, when there is a need, it is going to be supply the energy to it, so that it can control the fluctuations of the output. So fluctuations of the output can be controlled with the help of a flywheel. For design of the flywheel includes the parameters thickness, width, and mass. For this one, we have to draw a turning movement diagram. What is this turning movement diagram? Turning movement diagram contains torque values on y-axis and crank angle on the x-axis. So by considering these two, we are going to draw the turning movement diagram. Already in the previous classes, turning movement diagram concept I have explained. The same method we are going to follow for drawing this one. If you observe this one, the turning movement diagram of pit, I will read the problem for you. The turning movement diagram for a petrol engine is drawn to the following scales. Turning moment is 1 mm is equal to 5 Newton meter, and crank angle is 1 degree, 1 mm is equal to 1 degree. The turning movement diagram repeats itself at every half revolution of the engine. That means a revolution contains 360 degrees. For every 180 degrees, the same values will repeat, and the areas above and below of the mean turning moment line is given. So before drawing, all of you take a pen and paper, a notebook, and first you draw on y-axis the turning torque values, on x-axis you take a crank angle. It is given that the areas above and below, first value is above, second value is below. The mean turning moment line is order is 295, 685, 40, 340, 960, 270, like so on they have given. Determine the mass of that mass of 300 mm diameter flywheel. So the diameter of the flywheel is given as 300. Have to find the mass when the coefficient of fluctuation of speed is 0.3 and the engine runs at 1800 rpm. Also determine cross section of the rim when the width of the rim is twice of thickness. Assume density of the rim material as 7250 kg per meter cube. So this is the things they have given. Now let us solve the problem. For solving the problem, first y-axis is a torque values. Those are 295, 685, 40, 340, 960, 270. First value is up means second value is lower. So based upon the given data, I have drawn this one. You also observe the same diagram, and same diagram you have drawn on your paper. You draw on your paper or notebook. It is a torque turning moment diagram. First one is given as up, that is 295. Below value is given as 285. That means this is the below value we are going to take. Next one is it is up 40, down 340, up 960, down 270. Like this, you have to draw this one. If you observe the given diameter, 300 mm is there. They have converted into radians, and in turn they have converted into meters. quotient of fluctuation of speed is given as 0.3%. So by converting percentage into value, that is 0.003. N is the speed, that is 1800 rpm. So convert speed value into angular velocity, that is formula is omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. N value is 1800, so you have converted. That is 188.5 radians per second. Density they have directly given. Next, mass of the flywheel you have to found, that is in kgs. First of all, let us find the maximum fluctuation of energy. As per the given diagram or drawn diagram, maximum fluctuation of energy where it is we have to found. But they have given a scale, 1 mm is equal to 5 Newton meter, and the crank angle 1 degree is equal to 1 mm is equal to 1 degree. Thereby, pi by 180 is equal to radians. 1 mm square they have given. So on the turning moment diagram, 5 into pi by 180, that is 0.087 Newton meter. This value last we use for conversion. So converted the scale value into in terms of given angles, crank angle and turning moment diagram. Let us observe this one. If energy at B is equal to E plus 295, because first one is up. At C is 295 plus E plus 295 minus 685. That is answer is 390. Next, energy at D is E minus 390 plus 40, that is 350. Energy at E is equal to E minus 350 minus 340. Energy at F is equal to E minus 690 plus 960, that is plus 270. Energy at G is equal to E plus 270 minus 270, that is equal to 0. That means it is equal to E energy. If in all this one, if you observe, which is going to have a higher value? The higher value is plus 295. That is next. What the least value is? Minus E minus 690. So maximum fluctuation of energy is equal to E plus 295 and minimum energy is equal to 690. So maximum is 295, minimum is 690. So you can first find this fluctuation of energy. So maximum fluctuation of energy is equal to maximum energy minus minimum energy. Thereby we are going to obtain E plus 295 minus E minus 690. So that is 985 Newton meter. That we converted into 0.087. In the previous slide, we have converted that value 5 into pi by 180 is 0.087. So you multiply that one, then we are going to get this. Next, we also know that maximum fluctuation of energy del E is equal to m r square omega square Cs. That is quotient of fluctuation of energy. What is mass you have to found. Radius we have found it. Omega square we have converted. Cs is 0.003. Of all these parameters, unknown parameter is only m. So del E is equal to mr square omega square Cs. In that relation, you substitute the values. Thereby, mass is found. The mass of the flywheel is 35.8 kg. So first aim of the problem is to find the mass we have found. Next, second one is to find the cross section of the flywheel rim. Let T is the thickness rim in meters and B is the width of the rim in meters. As it is given, width is twice the thickness, that is B is equal to 2T. Then cross-section area of the rim is given by cross-section is equal to B into T. B is equal to TT. So area is equal to 2T square. We know that mass of the flywheel is 35.8. Then what is the volume? That circumference means area into 2 pi r into density. Everyone know that is mass is given, area into circumference, that is 2 pi r into density of a material. In this one, area is nothing but 2 t square. We know r value, we know the density value. So t value can be found. So t square is equal to 35.8 by 13,668. Thereby t is equal to 0.051 meters. If we convert into mm, that is 51 mm. Next, as b is equal to tt, so 2 into 51, that is 102 mm. So by this you have completed the problem. That means you have found second target as, that is find out in the dimensions of thickness and width. These two we have found it. So what we have ultimately have found it, we have found it three parameters. One is mass of the flywheel we have found. Second one is thickness. Third one is width. For this one, only one problem, one formula we have used. That is maximum fluctuation of energy is equal to m into r square into omega square into cs. So they will give this problem for total 14 marks in the university exam. First, draw the turning moment diagram, find which is maximum energy and which is minimum energy, and then find the maximum fluctuation of energy. From that one, you substitute the formula and you will get the mass, and mass is known, convert into mass is equal to rho into circumference into density. Thereby we are going to get the thickness and width. Now we will solve another problem for this one. So what is the difference here? If you observe, I will read the problem for you. The intercepted areas between the output torque curve and the mean resistance line of a turning moment diagram for a multi-cylinder engine taken in order from one end are as follows. That means it is starting from one end. What is the torque values? It is minus 35 plus 410 minus 285 plus 325 minus 335 plus 260 minus 365 plus 285 minus 260. So in the previous problem they have mentioned above and below. Here they have mentioned minus, that is positive sign and negative sign. So positive sign includes above the main line, negative sign includes below the main line. Let us have this one. The diagram has been drawn to a scale of 1 mm is equal to 70 Newton meter and 1 mm is equal to 4.5 degrees. So you take a paper and a pen and take torque values on y-axis and angle values, crank angle values on x-axis. The engine speed is 900 rpm and the fluctuation in speed is not to exceed 2%. So CS value is given in the similar value of the mean speed. Find the mass and cross section of the flywheel rim having 650 mm mean diameter. The same diameter they have given, that is a mean diameter. The density of the metal of the flywheel is may be taken as 7200. So flywheel they have given. The rim is rectangular with a width 2 times the thickness. So width is equal to 2 times the thickness. The same condition they have mentioned. The mainly difference is numerical values are changed. Instead of above and below, they have given positive sign and negative sign. First, take a paper and draw the turning moment diagram. First, you take lower value, that is minus 35. Next, plus 410, minus 285. Like this, you have to draw. Have drawn in a narration, you observe this one. So, first one is I have taken as a minus value. Second one is taken as a up value. Third one is minus, like so on. You have to draw for given all the cases. How many cases they have given? If you observe, minus 35 plus 410, that is one cycle. Minus 285 plus 325, another cycle. Minus 335 plus 260, another cycle. Minus 365 plus 285, one cycle. And once again, minus 260, that is another one. Four repeated cycles and one ordinary one, that means single cycle. You substitute all the values as per the given formula. Here have taken only two loops, but you are going to get four loops and one down value because it is given as minus. As it is similar to previous problem, I have taken narration of this one. You try to understand. Based upon these values, we are going to find out the fluctuation of energy. Let us observe the given data. Given data is n is equal to 900 rpm. Convert that into angular velocity, 2 pi into 900 by 60. It is omega 1 minus omega 2 is equal to 2% of the mean speed. Thereby, CS is equal to 2%, that is 0.02. Diameter of the wheel is given as 650 and R is equal to 325. Convert into meters. Density is given as 7200 kg per mm square. Mass of the flywheel. Let mass of the flywheel rim in kgs they have given. First of all, let us find the maximum fluctuation of energy. We are following the same methods as we have followed in the previous one. Turning moment diagram for a multi-cylinder is given. Already have drawn that one. So since the scale is given as 1 mm is equal to 70 Newton meter, and scale of the crank angle is 1 mm is equal to 4.5 degrees. Thereby 4.5 into pi by 180, we are going to get the value as pi by 480. Now pi by 40 radians. As they are given, 1 mm is equal to 1 degree, pi into 1 into pi by 180 into 1. So pi by 180 we obtained. But here pi into pi by 180 into 40 means that is 4.5 degrees. Pi by 180 into 4.5 degrees, we are going to get the value as pi by 40. 1 mm square on the turning moment diagram is 70. So 70 into pi by 40, thereby 5.5 Newton meter we have obtained. We will use this value for conversion. So let total energy at A is equal to E. As first one is negative, E minus 35. Energy at B. Energy at C is E minus 35 plus 410, that is E plus 375. Energy at D is equal to E plus 375 minus 285. Energy at E, E plus 90 plus 325, that is E plus 415. Energy at F is equal to E plus 415 minus 335, that is E plus 80. Energy at G is equal to E plus 80 plus 260, that is E plus 340. Energy at H is equal to E plus 340 minus 365, that is E minus 25. Energy at E is equal, K is equal to E minus 25 plus 285, that is 260. Energy at L is equal to E plus 260 minus 260, that is zero. So if you observe from energy values from B to L, highest energy is recorded in energy at E level and minimum energy is recorded at the level H. So E plus 415 is the highest level at E. Similarly, at H we have a least energy, that is at B we have a least energy, E minus 35. So maximum fluctuation of energy is equal to maximum energy minus minimum energy. Maximum energy is E plus 415 minus E minus 35. We have the 450 value. So 450 into 5.5, that is 2475 Newton meter. So 5.5 value is obtained from the previous slide. That's the conversion factor we have used. So this is 5.5, because 70 into pi by 40 is 5.5 newtons. So first you have found maximum fluctuation of energy is maximum energy minus minimum energy. Have taken the subtraction and that is converted into conversion for that is 2475. So del E formula we know that del E is equal to mass into R square into omega square into CS. Substitute the values here. As we know, del E is known. Mass is unknown, and we know the R square value. That means diameter they have given. We have gone for radius, and omega square they have given RPM, and we have converted into angular velocity. That is 94.26. Coefficient of fluctuation is 0.02. Of all these values, only unknown value is m. That is mass is equal to 2475 by 18.77. That is 132 kg. Next, find cross section. Cross section values depends upon thickness and width. So it is given thickness is width is equal to twice the thickness. That is T is equal to 2T. So area of cross section of the rim A is equal to B into T, thereby 2T square. Mass of the flywheel M is equal to area into 2 pi R, circumference of the rim into density of the material. Density is given as 7200. Radius is given as 0.325 as it is counted from the diameter. Mass we have found 132. And thereby T, thickness T square is equal to 132 by 29409. So we have obtained 0.0044. So T value in meters is 0.067. If you want to convert it into mm, you multiply with 1000, that is 67 mm. As width is equal to twice the thickness, 2 into 67, we have a 134 mm. So this is the another problem. Ultimately, we have found three. Mass we have found, thickness we have found, width we have found. In the previous problem, they have given above and below. In this problem, they have given positive and negative side. That is the only difference. I repeat once again. First, draw turning moment diagram. Find out which is maximum energy and minimum energy. Find fluctuation of energy. And thereby, substitute that values in a given formula. The formula you know, only single formula, M into R square into omega square into fluctuation of speed, percentage of fluctuation of speed. And thereby we are going to obtain mass value, because unknown value is only mass. From mass, you take mass is equal to 2 pi r circumference into area of this one. Area of the flywheel is given as B into T. Based upon that one, we can able to substitute the B value with respect to T, that will be T square. Then we can able to obtain this thickness. If thickness is known, twice the width is twice the thickness, we obtain this one. So this is a one problem. Next, we'll go for the another case. Here, I will read out the problem for you. A single cylinder double acting steam engine develops a power 150 kilowatts at a mean speed of 80 rpm. The coefficient of fluctuation of energy is 0.1 and the fluctuation of speed is plus or minus 2% of mean speed. If the mean diameter of the flywheel rim is 2 meters and the hub and the spokes provided 5% of the rotational inertia of the wheel. So 5% of rotational will be provided by the spokes. Find the mass of the flywheel and cross-section area of the rim. Assuming density of the flywheel material, which is cast iron, is 7200 kg mm square. here they have not given any torque values, but they have given power value. From power we can able to find the torque value, power, and from the torque once again you adopt the same formula so that we can able to find the parameters of the flywheel. Already I told in the beginning of the class, parameters of the flywheel is mass and cross section, that is thickness and width. Here problem they have given in terms of power instead of giving a mean torque, and all parameters are similar. I try to observe students. So this is the things we have. Flywheel having arms are there. So B value contains arm, and hub they have written at the center, and rim diameter is given. So we have to found. We have to find mass, thickness, and width. These are the parameters. The given values are like this. Power is given as 150 kilowatt. So convert it into watts. That is 150 is equal to, that is 103 watts. Next, speed is given as 80 rpm. CE, coefficient of fluctuation 0.1. W minus 1 W2 is equal to plus or minus 2%. Diameter is given as 2 meters, so we have converted R is equal to 1 meter. Density of the metal they have given. Let M is the mass of the flywheel in kgs. So convert that angular speed into radians, that is omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. N value is given. And by converting, we are going to get 8.4 radians per second. So 2 into pi, 180 into n value is 80 by 60. Fluctuation of speed is given as plus or minus 2% to the mean speed. So what is the mean speed? If you take total fluctuation of speed is omega 1 minus omega 2 is equal to 4% of mean speed. That is 0.04 into W. Quotient of fluctuation of speed is W minus W2. That is omega is equal to 0.04. We know that work done per cycle is equal to 36 twice into 150 into 10 into 60 into 80. Thereby it is 112.500 newtons. We know that coefficient of fluctuation of energy, that is C is equal to maximum fluctuation of energy work done per cycle. So what is the maximum fluctuation? That is CA into work done. So work done is going to be obtained as 112.50, and with respect to what is the CA, coefficient of fluctuation is 0.1. So 0.1 into 112.50. Thereby we are going to obtain this one. How this is going to be obtained? Work done is equal to power is equal to 2 pi n by 60. N we know, power is 350. 2 pi n by 60. Convert that value into that one. Then by n is equal to 80 rpm. Next, since 5% of rotational inertia is provided by hub and spokes, therefore maximum fluctuation of energy of the flywheel rim will be 95%. That means out of 100%, you deduct 5%. Why spokes and hub has to be neglected as per the given problem. So fluctuation of the rim will be about 95% only. Maximum fluctuation of energy of the rim is 0.95 into 112.50. Where we obtained 0.95, the percentage 112.50 is obtained from the previous case, that is here delta and maximum energy is equal to C into work done per cycle. So work per cycle you have removed, that is for every 60 degrees it is going to be make another operation. So C is equal to 0.1 into work done is given as 112500 newton meter. So Delhi is equal to be obtained, that is 10687.5 newton meter. Maximum fluctuation of energy at the rim is given, is equal to formula 10687.5 is equal to m into r square into omega square into cs. Thereby, in all this one, only unknown value is m value. That is, m is equal to 10687.5 by 2.82. Therefore, we are going to get 3790 kgs. Next, cross section area of the rim. It is given. Cross section area of the rim is equal to mass is equal to a into 2 pi r into p. So a value is unknown. 2 into pi value we know, 3.14. r value is diameter, it is given as 1 meter. Density is given as 7200. Out of all this one, a is unknown. So a value obtained. So thereby you have solved this one. So if you observe, you have found the two parameters. Cross section you have found, and you have found the mass of the flywheel. Well, compared to previous problems, the here problem is quite different. They have given power. Power is equal to 2 pi n by 60. That is, torque is equal to 2 pi n t by 60. So you have substituted that value. We observe this one. This is the thing we are going to observe here. That is, work done by the flywheel per cycle, that only we have calculated here. The value obtained is 112500 newton meter. That is 150 into per cycle is 360 degrees into the value is 0.1%. 60, what is RPM is N. So by using the formula, we have converted this multiplication of power into 360 into and RPM is equal to by 60. 2 pi nt by 60. By using that relation, we calculated the work done. So don't make understood this concept. And thereby, we have converted this work done. So work done into CE, that is 0.1, and thereby 112. So first we have calculated the maximum fluctuation of energy, work done per cycle. And coefficient of fluctuation has to be multiplied. Next, after that one, Delhi is equal to m into omega square m into r square into CS. So then same thing you have calculated as you have in the previous case. And the mass is known, the same formula. So by this, we have solved total three problems. First one is based upon mean and above and below values. So drawn turning moment diagram and calculate maximum fluctuation of energy, minimum energy, and subtraction of the two, we have got this value. That is, maximum fluctuation of energy is maximum energy minus minimum energy. From there, we have calculated using the formula mass. If mass is known, then cross section values are found. In the second problem, we have gone for negative and positive values to draw turning moment diagram, and you have found maximum energy, minimum energy, and maximum fluctuation of energy is maximum energy minus minimum energy. By using the formula, Delhi is equal to m omega square r square cs. Thereby, m value is found. If m is known, m is equal to a into 2 pi r, circumference into density. So area is equal to b into t, that is thickness into breadth. Based upon the relation, thickness, breadth is twice the thickness. You have found thickness first, and they have gone for this. In third problem, power is they have given. power is equal to 2 pi n by 60, 2 pi nt by 60, and we have to find the torque value. So torque is going to be found here. From the torque value, you have calculated the maximum fluctuation of energy, and thereby you have found the cross section area. So by this, I have completed this numerical part session. Have a good day, students. Take care. For complete notes is available in Google Classroom code 4FW5XCK. All are small letters. You can have a question is in the form of text messages to my mail ID chwr5@rediffmail.com. Complete notes is available in a link that is provided by the department. Use that link. Already that link is shared to you. Thank you, students. Take care. Bye.